All right, here it is. We're getting started in the season, right? But we want to stay sharp. We want to get better. We want to be stronger as basketball officials. And the way we do that is we analyze game video, learn what we can. Let's get started today. Let's go. Greetings and welcome back to another episode of Five Play Friday, the show where we analyze game videos so that we can take things and get better as basketball officials. Greetings again, everybody. It's Greg Austin with A Better Official, abetterofficial.com. We craft video to help basketball officials get better and take control of their officiating career. One of the ways that we do that is we analyze game video so we can get better as basketball officials. Without further ado, let's get started and look at play number one. Right out of the gate here, we've got a block charge play. What do you have on this play? In the comments below, put what you have. Block, charge. See if we can get this play right. And let's move on now to play number two. All right, transition officiating, right? It's a key component in our game. The way we work in the front court is one thing. The way we work in transition and looking at habits and fundamentals in transition. A lot of times here on Five Play Friday, we look at plays and we say, look at all the things the crew did wrong, right? But when we analyze game video, we have to look at positives. What are the positives? What are the habits and fundamentals that we can emulate in our own game? So in this play, we have a hard foul at the end. We're going to make judgments about whether this foul is a common foul or whether we need to upgrade. But when we analyze our game video, we're looking at all the things. And so that's what we're going to do here, is look at the habits and fundamentals exhibited by the crew. Really important on this play to do that. So if we start at the very beginning, right, our crew is in good position for this rebounding action. Our trail's coming in a little late. I don't know how we got there necessarily. And then in transition, center official has the middle third. Open look on the defender coming up. Nothing going on. Notice our trail as well has moved really quickly down the court and is great position right here, right? Oftentimes we look at our game video and the trail is late to the party, right? So we're in great shape here. We have a call by the center and then doubled by the lead on this hard foul. Both officials recognize the hard foul. Look at our trail official here as well, right? Big picture view. Not coming in, not turning away, etc. We know our two other officials are engaged. Trail official has the big picture view. I like stepping to the three-point line as well. These are all great habits and fundamentals. So our lead, maybe a touch late getting to the end line. our center in great position here, and our trail in fantastic position here, because we could have a restricted area play or something like that, and our trail needs to be engaged here as well. And possibly we have our two other officials stacked, and the trail would be the only one who could see arm contact, etc., right? So when we look at this clip, when I look at this clip, what I see are great habits and fundamentals by the crew. Hard foul, closed down. We're communicating. Yeah, maybe a little more hustle from our lead so that they were in position on the catch. That would be my one quibble, right? We want to make sure in this situation where the players are coming in that the right players are going to the right people, right? And we don't want white going to blue while they're on the floor, or blue going to white while they're on the floor. So being aware there, our trail officials in great position for a big picture view here as well. So an obvious foul in transition, looking at the habits and fundamentals exhibited by the crew, right? That's our big takeaway here. If I'm looking at my game video, am I doing what this trail is doing? Am I getting up the court fast enough to be here, right here, right? Perfect spot to help on that play if we didn't have a call from the outs, from the other officials, right? Am I hustling enough as lead? Am I in good position as center? I think we have great position as center here. Right? Open look. Transfer eyes. Hard foul. Now we need to make a judgment about whether we're going to upgrade this call or not, but great work by our crew on this play. So when we analyze our game video, we're looking for mistakes that we make. When we analyze other plays, we're looking for the mistakes that the crew may have made. But we always, always, always have to take away the positives. What did we do well? What habits and fundamentals that other people exhibit can we take and bring into our own game? And this clip is a great example of that. So many positives to take away. So some tremendous points, teaching points, habits and fundamentals exhibited by the crew in transition. Those positives are what we want to take into our game so that we can be better as basketball officials. Let's move on now to another transition play, play number three. All right, transition plays can catch us by surprise, but our crew's in great position here. Lead knows he's got to get on his horse, but there's not a lot of defensive action. Got a lead marking a three. Did we ever do that in high school? Does the lead ever mark the three in three-person transition? Block charge play at the basket. Obvious illegal contact. But something we want to look at here is the transition action by the crew, right? And we can look, of course, at all of the things. Our crew's in good position here, and we're going the other way, right? As new lead, we want to pick up what is potentially going to happen. Who are the defenders I need to officiate? In this instance, player pulls up near the three-point line. Our lead marks, but we note that the trail is not yet in the front court. That's helpful. Possible travel by white there. Block charge play, obvious block, illegal defender. Now we've got two officials moving. What does our tableside official do, right? We want a big picture view here, knowing that our other two officials are moving. Pretty good, pretty good. This is a collegiate game, so we're staying opposite the table here. Come to the reporting area, right? All good, all good. A lot of great habits and fundamentals exhibited on this play. And we like that. And we want to take those habits and fundamentals and say, do I measure up? Could I do better? Am I lacking? Oh, I'd like to be able to do that, be that aware, or this, that, and the other thing, right? So obviously in high school, the lead can help mark a three-point try in transition when the trail is not yet in the front court, something that we can help with. This play wasn't super close, but it's a great habit to have. But you have to get on your horse here. Let's see if our trail gets into position as well as we'd like here. Our center and lead are in great position, right? Our trail's coming down. Yeah, we're looking good here, right? Everybody's in great position, and we're in great position here to officiate the subsequent action. Did we miss a travel on the perimeter? That's what I want to know. This little Fred Flintstone running action before he puts the ball down. All right, that play was submitted by Chris Janish, right? Chris has submitted a number of transition plays for us here today. If you want to submit a play, I'll put a link down in the show notes below so that you can have your play on Five Play Friday. All right, fantastic. Hey, let me take a moment to thank our tremendous show supporters. Tom Hickey, Yvette Perry, Richard McGuire, Jose Lansang Jr., and Darwin Sonata. Much appreciated and much love. You want to support the show? There'll always be a link down in the show notes below. What? Oh, you want me to? Okay. And I'm going to put one right here. Thanks, everybody. Hey, another great transition play. Let's take a look at another great transition play. Play number four. All right. So we don't want to get beat as lead. No, we can never allow that to happen, right? But sometimes the game says you are going to get beaten on this play, right? Something surprising happens. The ball is batted in this case, and we are out of position, right? It is going to happen, and we need to learn to how to handle those situations and recognize what we have, right? So rebound batted, breakaway. Right? Our lead is beaten. Our center is in excellent position, has the call. Looks like hip contact from behind. Let's look at all of the things. If you are the center, you have the post action here and the ball's kicked out. A little late in this instance, we want to position adjust while the ball is in flight on the pass, right? To step down to get an open look on this play. But in the end, we have a relatively uncontested three. Want to stay with our shooter, rebounding, and our crew right here is in great position, right? Now, our trail is in a low position here. Now, why would they end up in this position? Because the ball goes into the post on the opposite side. As trail, we want to naturally step down, anticipating what? We anticipate our lead is going to come across when the ball has settled on that side. So we are in a relatively low position as trail. Try goes up. We're in great position for rebounding action. Something happens on the opposite side of the lane. Again, our crew is a little out of position. If our lead was strong side here on this play, we'd have a better look at that. See if we have anything there. I don't think anything is there. The ball's batted, and we are surprised, right? Right. So at this moment, you are the new lead. You know you're the new lead, right? What behavior do we need to exhibit here? We need to make a decision, right? I'm going to give everything I have, right? And like that baseball analogy of, you know, a bunt single, right? The batter is out of the box. They are 100% sprinting, right? That's what we have to have in this situation. You just got to, and then you have to make a decision. Am I going to be able to beat the play to the end line, or do I need to pull up and get a look at the play, right? Our responsibility is to be able to officiate the play, not necessarily to beat the play to the end line. This is a unusual situation, how we've gotten ourselves here, but we are out of position. We just recognize that, and we have to go, right? So 100% sprint, make a decision. Do I pull up? Do I not? Where is my partner, right? Do I want to aggressively go after this call as new lead, or do I want to maybe have a more secondary cadence if there's no whistle from my center, who I know is in great position? I'm in a weak position as new lead. My center is in great position, right? Should I fight to get to put a whistle on this play, or should I allow my center to have the best look, the best possible position to make the call? Right? They have the angle on that body bump by the defender. I don't think we ever get a trail on this play. Right? So a great example, in my mind, of the situation we have when we are beaten on a play and decision making, right? One decision here would be to pull up right past the coach, so we get a stationary view, because there's no way we're going to beat that play to the end line. But don't we often see leads in this situation fight to be the one to make the call, but allow the system to work. We know that our center's in great position. They can put a great whistle on the play, and we look good as a crew. Yep. I agree. I mean, but we make decisions, right? We are on the court. We are in a certain circumstance has exhibited itself, and we make decisions. I'm going to try to beat that play to the end line. I'm going to try to complete this rotation, even though I realize a try is going up, right? I'm sort of at a point of decision-making. I want to get an open look. I'm going to step down. Oh, they step down with me. I have a closed look, right? We make decisions. We make the best possible decisions that we can in real time on the court. Sometimes, believe it or not, those decisions prove to be not the best, right? If I'd made another decision, I would have had a better look, right? But we just need to train ourselves to realize we need to make decisions, learn from our mistakes, so we can get better as basketball officials. Come on now. Yeah, I always like to stress, and I always want to, all right, so it's going to change. My thinking is going to change. I'm lead on this play. This is my play. I am beaten on this play. Am I in a strong position, or am I in a weak position? Do I know that my partner is in a strong position or in a weak position, right? If I knew that my crew was in the backcourt and it's all on me, then I'm going to make a decision about my cadence on a whistle, etc., right? But if I know that I'm weak and my partner's strong, right, why don't I just let them? I trust them. I know they're going to put a whistle on a play if it's a foul, right? I will give them first crack. No whistle, that's a foul. Boom, I'll come late as lead in the situation. Understanding where your crew is and who's strong, who's weak, who's out of position, who was caught, etc. If we can have that in our game as well, we are better off and better to be, we're better able to be an excellent crew official, right? Officiating where our partners cannot, or letting our partners officiate where we cannot. So often, even though it's a play in our primary, we'll get a whistle sometimes from a partner because they had the angle. They saw the swipe down, even though it was in our primary and we had mostly a good look, but they had the great look. Yeah, that would be really be my takeaway on a play like this, is understanding your strength as an official, where your crew is, right? I'm in a weak position. My partner's in a strong position. Let them have the call. I'm not going to fight for it just because. I'm not going to fight for it for any sort of sense of embarrassment, like, oh, I was lead and I got beaten on this play. There is no official on planet Earth who on this play, as trail, is not going to be beaten from the position they are on the court, right? The ball is batted. There's no way we could anticipate that. And if we were anticipating that, we're not in position to officiate the previous play, right? So there's no embarrassment in not having a whistle here, right? This is a great example of strength because we're understanding the system and how we can leverage it to our best advantage. What are these guys spelling over here? Let's see. What is going on here? Go. I don't know what it spells. And could we jumble those guys to do something interesting? Like, do they have choreographed movements where they can, you know, say, ref, you suck, you know, respell the words? You know, if we're going to invest time and energy in the letters and the we got to have some variations. We got to be able to do some choreography, you know, with clapping and then repositioning like a marching band, you know, moving together. And yeah, they got to up their game. Oh, all right. So great transition plays. Let's take a look at play number 5. All right, transition. Center has to transition from previous action, subsequent action. They are responsible. That is a secondary defender. She belongs to the lead. No call by the lead. Center stays engaged, puts a whistle on the play, right? So when we analyze our game video, we're going to have transfer of the eyes situations, which we have here. Right? Our center is responsible, a little bit out of position here, maybe a little bit too far up the court here, but is responsible, oh, I see, for, you know, this action here, these players here, etc. The ball gets thrown ahead, right? And at this key moment, we've got to transfer our eyes because we have a quick defensive player, could have illegal contact there as well. Player goes to the basket. Is this a foul? Got no whistle on the play. No foul there. I've got A to B, right? We see how our offensive player is contacted and shifts their weight. Foul is ruled, but a good transit, you know, when we're in transition as center, especially, sometimes we're officiating back, the ball gets thrown ahead and we have to officiate forward, right? And doing that transfer of the eyes is important. We want to be good at that. And then we want to stay connected with plays. Did our official make a mistake here? Is that a foul? Let's take a look. Secondary defender, definitely A to B, definitely contact in the torso. Whistle on the play. I like it. That official, I think that's called correct. I'm sticking with that. Yeah, it's tough on these plays when the action is, and I think we're a little out of position, like I say, but staying with the play right here, when the player releases the ball, sometimes things happen to, you know, there's contact with that defender at that moment, and you realize you've looked away too quickly. So a little challenging from this spot. And then we have subsequent action here. We could have a possible rake across the arm or body contact, but nothing. I would say that secondary defender would belong to the lead. This guy's always calling outside of it. No. All right, let's go back and take a look at play number one. Did the official get the call correct? What can we learn on that play? Let's review play number one. All right, great block, transition play, possible bump, body bump in transition. Beats the defender here. Secondary defender sets up. Patience, no. Center has a call, it's a charge. This play was from a few years ago. A lot of good things to look at here. This is on a collegiate floor, but this is a high school game. Very large tournament here in the beautiful San Francisco Bay Area. All right. Initial position of the crew on the previous play. Let's take a look. This game was late at night. Right? We're in pretty good position. Center's up pretty high. I don't know why. Block. And then this initial looks like a body bump. No call there. We are in transition. Second, there we have defender here swiping down. No contact. Get to stationary. Possibly could have waited a tick longer as center since that's a lead primary. But we have a charge. Is this a charge? What do we have on this play? Let's take a look. Our defender. That offensive player has not left the floor. And our defender has their left foot in position. The restricted area, even though it's marked here, and this is a high school game, is not in effect. Was it in? I think we have call correct. Old school mechanics. This was from a few years ago, of course. We would never, ever show the punch now, here in 2022. No. And what we also see is our center fails to designate the spot. And the failure to designate the spot leaves our crew in a weak position. Our trail, or our new trail, is going to bring the ball in opposite, right? Our center, an old center, is moving down the court. We are going to be out of position for this subsequent call, subsequent play. We'd like to improve that. Bang, bang, play very early in the game, first period action. And that's what we have. Does that match up with what you had? Let us know in the comments. Ay, ay, ay. Now, let's look at our previous play and the position of our lead. Are they at, right? Are they in a position where they feel that they should have the primary whistle on this play? Or are they, as we discussed previously, recognizing their partner's in a better position, right? I've got players moving in front of me. For whatever reason, we're not yet engaged in the game or what have you. We can always, just in that moment, say, I'm going to be, rather than be assertive here, I'm going to be patient. If I get no whistle from my partner who's in great position, then I will put a whistle on the play. Obviously, we need a whistle on this play. So that may be a factor as well. Is our lead in the best possible position to adjudicate this play? No. Right? We just recognize that. It was close. We can look at the veracity of the call. Right? We're watching our defender, our secondary defender. Right? This player turned out to be definitely a charge taker. That was sort of her role. Is any chance there was to take a charge, she was trying to do it. Of course, we're very early in the first period here. Our player has not yet left the floor, but it is close. Her feet are on the floor. Our defender is legal. She firms up, right? She does not move forward. She just basically gets taller, elevates, strengthens her body. I got a charge. All right, five plays in. Love it. Love analyzing game video. Why don't we do this? Why don't we take a look at a bonus play? And if I press the right button, we can look at the bonus play. Why don't we do this? Why don't we take a look at a bonus play? All right, transition play into the front court. Our lead late, getting into position. Doesn't rotate. Center is on an island, a staggered double screen. Rule an illegal screen. Move to the reporting area. Clear the players. Strengthen reporting. And go. And know what happens next. Right? Relatively simple illegal screenplay. Couple things we can look at. Right. So we see our lead. We get this circumstance. We love it. We love it as new lead, where we are headed down the court and the offensive player puts themselves very close to the sideline, and we have to run through the area between the player and the bench. Of course, we're always concerned about when we step near out of bounds, we're going to bump into the coach, we're going to trip, we're going to be injured, we're going to hit the table, we're going to do all sorts of things, right? But we end up in this sort of shoot that puts us not necessarily in the strongest position as lead for a potential rotation here. And usually in this situation, we also have to have our head down and not looking at players, because of the circumstance we have where we're moving between people, right? Love it when I'm being facetious, of course. But our ball is on the left side. We're in pretty good position here in the end, right? Obviously, got six-player action. The lead considers a rotation here. If they had to come earlier, maybe we're in better position as lead to help on this screening action. But in the end, our center is left with the ball coming at them, and then two subsequent screening action that develop in front of them, right? A tough situation. We're on an island. Sometimes that happens in our game where we would love to have other officials who are able to help. In this situation, we do not. And we've got a screening, a moving opponent situation. White 30. Our defender is moving. Do not give them time and distance. Illegal screen is ruled. Right? Just a good example, I think, of a play where we are on an island and it's all ours and there's no help coming. Right? In that situation, we have to just recognize that fact, call the play as the best we can. This play sort of presents itself to the center official. So just a good reminder that sometimes we're on an island and we just got to officiate that play. Yes, that's definitely a thing, especially if a team is running an offense where they're running this kind of action where they are, you know, a late. So how would we describe this action? This pass and cut to the ball and set a screen, right? And they're running this double screen action here. This is a designated, play that they are running. We have our shooter in the corner. We want to get him the ball and get him a shot, get him the ball. Screen one, screen two, right? If we recognize that and can anticipate that, it helps us for sure. Hey, thanks for joining us today for Five Play Friday. Much appreciated. If you would take a moment, do all of the things, I'd appreciate that as well. Like, subscribe, and notify so you don't miss out on any of our new content. Allow me to thank our tremendous show supporters. Tom Hickey, Yvette Perry, Richard McGuire, Jose Lansang Jr., and Darwin Sonata. Much appreciated and much love. There's a link in the show notes, and I'm going to put one up above. Tremendous. We have additional video content for you here. Our 2 5 Play Friday episodes. Mike Williams, a tremendous episode. Sadiq Pettijohn, a tremendous episode. Join us for the next video, and we'll see you there. Take care, everybody.